As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, are all people following the tariqah made from the same light?
Alhamdulillah, that we just talked about light. So, alhamdulillah. It's good. The questions are always good, although I may sound sarcastic, I'm not, because I'm trying to point out how the answers usually come before the questions. Because everybody is in attendance because Allah's calling them. And Allah calls the one to listen, the one to speak, because the one who speaks also wants to listen. So we're all in the same audience. So sometimes may sound sarcastic, but more to point out, oh look, this is what was talked about. That was the whole reality, is that we are a spectrums of light. So how could everybody be the same spectrum? No two have the same secret. Even in sainthood, Allah gave every saint their unique secret and gave them in such a loving generosity that they feel they have the most amazing and important secret, and that they are so special because Allah's love is such an intimate love for them, they can't imagine that Allah gave what He gave to them to anyone else. But in all humility they know above every knower there's infinite knowers. But the stress here is that no two have the same of anything, not their light, not their reality, not their secrets. Even if they sound the same, they're different. Even between the student and his shaykh, what Allah gave his student when he reached sainthood is nothing compared to what the shaykh can be completely different, where the shaykh can't speak about that reality, but the student was given that trust. So it means it has nothing to do with things that we can understand, but what was talked about tonight, light is infinite. And Allah doesn't need to recycle. Allah gave to everyone a unique name, a unique attribute, a unique light, and a unique reality that is uniquely theirs. And that the role of the shaykh is to bring people to their trust, that what did they promise Allah. And that's what's important, and that's why when they follow the tariqah, they take the bayat, they follow, they bring down their nafs, they do their awrads, their zikrs, so that the form is crushed. As a result of the form being crushed, they enter more into the world of light, and all of this is based on the world of light. Means there's nobody who can fulfill their promise from the world of form. That's when we talked about guidance, that this is a wave reality, that the particle is not Allah didn't promise anybody something from the particle realm. But Allah promised your trust, your reality, why I created you is in your wave reality. And our life is then to reach that wave reality. And once we reach to that wave reality, our reality becomes more and more clear. If you're created to be for love and to emit love and to emit guidance, you can only do that through the wave reality. So it means that you be crushed, your form be crushed as a result of being nothing, then what you emanate from a wave can touch the entire earth and beyond. There are spiritual beings that every time these associations start, they are attuned to those realities to pick up the frequencies and the coordinates that's necessary for them. So from every dimension and from every direction, Allah is sending a guidance, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Can we change from a liquid state back to a solid state through bad character and wrong choices?
Most definitely. That can you change from a the most difficult one is to change from solid to liquid. And as a result of burn and trial and difficulty, that the one whom becomes liquid and sort of soft and soft in nature, if they stop their practices and stop what brought them to their liquid state, their nafs will quickly make them back into a solid state and again become intolerant and different characteristics that are not of a liquid characteristic. But again, they can be melted quickly. So the initial melting is the most difficult because the person doesn't know the path, doesn't know exactly what's happening, they have a continuous intention. That's what we said before, there has to be a very strong bond. That there's a scene in one of the videos our people posted where it was in a movie, Dr. Strange, where the person is coming to understand a reality and they grab the hand of the student and with the other hand hit very hard into the chest and immediately the person's soul for dramatic purposes comes flying out. But that has a deep reality that if you're going to be hit with testing, the shaykh's obligation is to tie you. And that's why they keep telling people, commit yourself, that give sponsorship, give donations, be committed, do your khidmat, write article, whatever it is that you can do, the shaykh's responsibility is to tie the student because they know that everyone's going to run. If you don't have any tying and you're not anchored, and that's like a ship, you're like a ship in the ocean of Allah's immense love. Don't you think the wind would make you drift away? So your life is then to throw an anchor down. But because the student is not understanding the necessity of the anchor and his nafs is tricking him, oh don't give them anything, don't support anything, just sit there and listen for free. Your ship is not anchored to anything. So the minute some sort of disappointment or disagreement in what you think you understood or what shaitan whispered to you of an understanding, what happens? Your ship is drifting way off course and before you know it you're so far out that it's very difficult to come back. So the shaykh's responsibility is for the student, tie him down, anchor them into the program, anchor them into the tariqah by giving, by supporting, by their khidmat. Like we said before, our whole life was like that, that I've given so much of my time, of my possessions, of my wealth, where I'm going to go? And I'm going to start this over again? And I have to re-establish myself and re… People don't do it for dunya, they say, oh I have seniority. How could I leave this great job of seniority and start as a freshman and new and carry boxes and do like this for what? I have all this seniority. So imagine seniority in Allah's way, that I did and established and I gave everything and I'll go start with another person from day one? No. So then you're so tied, you're not going anywhere. Once you're not going anywhere, you find that then the testing becomes much more difficult because you're now anchored into this ocean. Allah send you a tornado, even your boat will start to go and levitate off the ocean even, but you're so anchored it's not going, it's not leaving that ocean. And that's the importance of tariqah, that's why they pull people in and get them to support, to contribute, to be involved. Because you're going to blow around and some people may, you know, blow and not be interested and not interested. All of a sudden, a couple years later, they're interested again because they're anchored, they're not, there's nowhere for them to go. Allah will move them around and again they settle back down and decide that they want to continue their path and finish their reality and reach to their reality inshaAllah. So it's filled with the immense Divine wisdoms. If people just suit up and show up and to control the whisperings, don't let shaitan whisper anything to you. It's a proven system that has been around for thousands of years, just do it and you'll achieve like they achieve. And a symbol is look how they teach, this is not from any book, these are not from any videos. If you want what they have then follow that one that is a symbol of that. And they'll give to you from what they have and that's the miracle of tariqah. They don't levitate off the ground, they're not magicians, but the knowledge is that that one speaks, I've never heard that anywhere, that's what I want. And that becomes the food for the servant. The students, they're eating from that reality, they said, this is what I want to eat so much of it until one day I can prepare a dish like that. and then that they become bound into it, tied into it, they become tested, their form becomes broken down. That's the difficult one. So when they become broken down, then they're between liquid, liquid. If they continue to break down, the shaykh's energy then will keep like a magnifier, keep burning them, burning them, burning them. And we said, now the dunya is doing that. We saw it in a Spider-Man movie, but in reality it's actually here, where the clever people said, you know, why are we making weapons that combust? Why we don't just take a big mirror, place it by the sun and then direct it onto a building? You know, they can burn cities with a mirror of the sun and the power of the light of the sun. So they're understanding in dunya. So imagine the ones whom their souls are like mirrors to something far more powerful than the sun, which is the light and the love of Sayyidina Muhammad that burns but nobody gets hurt. It brings immense lights and grace and love that they feel themselves on fire but nobody's hurt. This is a fire of Divine love and grace, and that they begin to burn. From liquid they become ethereal, that they begin to have all sorts of hal and experiences. Because liquid you can boil at any 2 seconds, you boil them. 2 seconds they sit in the zikr, the shaykh will be cooking them and they begin to fly, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Are there any physical signs that indicate we are melting, like weight loss or any physical sign?
That you're melting when your taste for things begins to go. When you struggle so much with everything, your taste to fight everything begins to go. Square-headed, Mawlana Shaykh would describe, they're like block-headed, square-headed people. Because square you can't put it into anything except square. So those, they're symbolized by the Wahhabis. Very square-headed, that you do this is kufr, you do this is shirk, you do this is bid'ah. And he would describe the four sides, because everything to them is wrong. So you can't move, you can't move forward, you can't move backwards, everything is innovation, everything is a disbelief, everything is a partnership. So then the symbol of that and the sort of the joke of that was that intolerant with everything. As soon as you burn and be melted with that, you find yourself more tolerant. You find that, I just don't have the energy to put in another argument, and you'd rather just go on your carpet and cry that you're giving up, I just don't want to do it, I'm finished with it, I don't want to talk, I don't want to argue with anyone. And that in, that fire is no longer external and becomes internal, and they feel themselves heating up, they feel themselves drawing closer to Allah. That who are they going to argue with when they've been cut off from the physical world and somebody didn't give them what they promised to give them or whatever was going to happen, and they find that there is no resolution with physical, and they take their concern to Allah and they cry to Allah and they resolve their cases with Allah and Sayyidina Muhammad and they become internalizing this energy. And they're not trying to fight everyone, trying to correct everyone, to fire off a letter to somebody. They say that no one on the outside can resolve my issue if it's not Allah resolving it through Prophet. Then they begin to internalize that reality, they're meditating, contemplating, they have a strong connection in their muraqabah. So they would know all these things. It's not like, oh, I stayed quiet for 2 weeks and now in the grocery store I feel like fire is coming on me, I must have reached something. So that's why those types of questions you would know when you're seeing your shaykh in your meditation. You would know that the energy and the fire is that reaching to you. You would know that you feel like a fire has been sent from him, you see a fire coming towards you, and that you're breathing and bringing these energies on. So these are things that the student will witness. And they'll witness the heat, they'll witness the energies, and then they have a very strong connection in their muraqabah. It's not happening randomly at the grocery store, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
What fills the space between the electrons and the nucleus of our atom?
What fills the space between the electron and the nucleus? I have no idea. They say it's an empty space, but nothing is empty. All that we have to know is that that spin and rotation is the reality of our manifestation. And the distance between these seven rings are the seven levels of heaven. Means that your paradise is your nucleus, and you have seven rings to your outermost reality. So you have seven names, and just for our understanding and teaching, you have these seven electrons, one on each ring to reach towards the center, the nucleus. Your journey is not out, but your journey is in. So means that my electrons, they're all spinning. And why are they spinning? We described before, centrifugal force, it's actually the mass attraction that Allah gave them, a love that they want to reach the nucleus. Everybody has a love for the Divine, it's in their atomic reality. So an atheist on the form, he says, oh I'm atheist, I'm agnostic, oh that's his crazy nafs. But his atoms, they're created from Divine love. How is he manifesting if the electrons are not spinning because of love to reach the nucleus? And everybody makes hajj, they want to, they don't want to, Allah has the whole earth spinning around and making hajj. Everyone's electrons are spinning and making hajj around the nucleus. So it means whatever Allah wants, it happens. But He gave people the ability to have an ego that says, I don't want to do it. But doesn't mean they're not doing it. It means everything follows Allah's will. He's Rabbul Mu'mineen wa Rabbul Kafireen. He's Lord over all His creation, and means His Lordship is they're doing it. They're all making hajj, and they're all submitting, and they're all created from love. And that's why your electrons are spinning, because they want to go to the nucleus and Allah doesn't give them a permission. As a result of fast spinning, it begins to rise. So everybody has that love, and those electrons are trying to reach to the nucleus. So it means they want to know themselves. Who knows himself will know his nucleus. No, will know his Lord. His Lord is located in the nucleus, emitting a tremendous love. So they're all on a journey to know their Lord. And you know that the electron can only jump a ring from a power that's emitted. So a lightning has to hit the electron from the nucleus. It's a lightning bolt that hits it and then brings the electron on the ring closer to the center. Our life is all about the journey on these seven rings, Lord of the Rings. Why was it Lord of the Ring? Because there are seven rings that we must traverse to reach the center, and our whole life is about that reality, is going in and going in and in and in. And each time Allah has to give an ishara to the sultan sends an energy that hits and that pulls the person to move closer and closer. So all of these are actual spiritual events, none of this is philosophy. And the one who experiences it, they know exactly what the shaykh is talking about. And if the one who doesn't, they're always wondering, did this happen to me yet? No, it's not a philosophy class. If you haven't been hit by something, no, it didn't happen to you yet. If you didn't see lights that enter into your heart and visions of lights coming, then the light of faith has not entered into the heart. They're not philosophy events, they're actual physical events, spiritual events that will take place within the heart and soul of a student, inshaAllah. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.